Hi there everyone, welcome back to the channel. As you guys already know, I mentioned in my previous videos is that I actually want to sort out the injury of the Honda VTEC, because I'm not sure if you guys will be able to see that, but this valve cover is quite dirty. On camera it actually looks like perfect, but I actually want to change the color, so I'm going to change that to a gray, and I need to respray this bracket right here as well, because it's quite rusty. So I'm gonna try to rescue that bracket, and as you guys can see in this area right here, well, it needs some TLC. What we're gonna do today is that we are gonna respray the valve cover, respray a few brackets, and get that area sorted which the battery was previously located. So we're gonna get that sorted, and a few things you will be needing for today's video. You will be needing most of these products right here. So what I have right here is some paint stripper. This will make it easy for me to actually get the paint removed from the valve cover. And if you guys didn't know this, I actually have some wrinkle paint on the valve cover. If you guys don't know how to do that, I'll explain to you guys how to do a wrinkle paint in today's video. All you guys need is this VHT Wrinkle Plus in whatever color you would like your valve cover to resprayed, or whatever like car piece or car part you want resprayed. And obviously I'll recommend using a heat gun, but in my current situation this blow dryer works perfectly fine to get that wrinkle out of like the paint. So these two right here, and the sanding paper, well, and the blow dryer, that will be for the valve cover. To get the car sorted there in the corner where the battery was previously located, I will be using some sanding paper just to sand that area down, get the fuse box out of the way, get the fuse out of the way, disconnect the battery at the back, and just get that area perfectly prepped so I can just give it a nice or a few coats of white spray. I actually got this white spray right here, not a very very good brand to be honest, but I'll definitely recommend the Rust-Oleum. But it's only like a little bit in, so well, this is the only spray I actually have at the moment, so it will have to do. I got myself some primer as well, just in case. I'm gonna try the primer out. The primer didn't work that great. Well, the previous time I actually used it. And obviously we have the black glue devil spray, which I use on most of my cars. I actually had some Rust-Oleum, but I gave like the half of the can to Jody, so I'm left with the glue devil to actually get like these small brackets, like this one right here, that one right there, and maybe like a few other brackets sprayed in the process. And that's basically about it. I'm gonna get you guys on the stand real quick, so I'm gonna start stripping the valve cover, stripping that area real quick, and getting that reservoir bracket removed. As you guys can see, I got the fuse box removed. I got all those wires removed in this area. I actually got all the wires in this bag right here, and I pulled all the other wires going like to the starter and to whatever locations, like the AB sensor. Got that unplugged and got that just removed. This luma right here, I'll just use some masking tape to cover that when I'm going to respray. Obviously the same applies with the econ lines, and obviously this power wire running through here. I think I might just push that back, but for now I'm just gonna start sanding this down here real quick. You guys can also see I got the valve cover removed, and I got the bracket removed for that reservoir right there. So I have everything, well, right here. Here's the bracket, and you guys can see it's in a very terrible state. So I think I might just use some, well, paint stripper for that bracket, and I'm definitely gonna use the paint stripper for the valve cover. And obviously I'm gonna start with that area right there, so I'm just gonna start sanding it down. Hopefully I can make some good progress in this time. So I'm gonna put you guys on the stand real quick while I start sanding down this area. Then I'm gonna start to respray it with the white can of spray I have right there. As you guys can see right here, Taren really started with the valve cover. Taren hasn't been here in a while, so well, he came to come help me out. So he's stripping the valve cover with some paint stripper. All you do, you just apply the paint stripper, let it like sit like for 5 to 10 minutes, then you start scratching it off. As you can see here, the valve cover was previously blue, so we must probably have to strip all the red off and then afterwards strip all the blue off, because this piece right here actually won chrome once again, as well as the Mugen. So as I have to well prep it very perfectly. And then here I actually sprayed some degreaser on here, so you actually got this area fully prepped. You can see most of the, like the surface rust is already removed, so all I need to do is just clean up this area and hopefully cover up most of the wires and like piping and aircon piping and stuff like that. Then you can actually start with the first few coats, but I'm gonna put you on the stand real quick for Taren, so Taren will start stripping the valve cover. Just an update. Fucking update. Just a quick update for you guys. As you guys can see, I got this area sprayed. I'm not completely done with this area, and unfortunately, like in areas like those at the bottom, I couldn't get like it sanded all the way properly down there. And as you guys can see right here as well, I didn't get it like properly sanded. I was a little bit impatient, but the progress this far looks simply amazing. I just tape it off here, tape it off there, well, tape it off here on top, and taped off all the piping as well. Taren on the other end is almost done with the valve cover, like stripping the valve cover, because you guys can see, well, most of the metal is showing already. So we're just giving it the last coat of the paint stripper, and then as soon as we're done here, we're gonna let it sit for another 10 minutes. Then we're gonna get all the paint removed, get it sanded down, and get it ready for spray, because like I said, we're gonna use the grey wrinkle plus for the valve cover. It's gonna look hella sweet when I'm done with it. And obviously, well, the bracket is here somewhere. Still need to prep the bracket, but oh, there's the bracket laying right there. Just need to prep the bracket, but this far we're making some good progress. I wish I could like respray this area here as well. I might just attempt that in the future, but I need to remove a lot of stuff to actually access this area right here. So I most probably need to remove the mounting, this bottle, the aircon piping, and I don't feel for that. I think the aircon piping I can just move out of the way, but like the mounting and this bottle right here, I definitely need to remove to respray this area. But I'm first gonna see how this looks compared to the rest of the body. Unfortunately, it won't have that shine to it as the rest of the engine, as you guys can see right here. It has a nice shine to it, but at least it won't look that rusty anymore. So I'm very keen to see how it's gonna look after like I remove all this and then compare to the rest of the engine bay, because I actually used some primer for the first two coats, and then I actually went through with the other can of white spray. Well, can't find the white can. Oh, here's the white can. Went through with this one right here, and I think I might just top it up with this white, well, gloss protective layer. So that's the update for now. So I'll just give you guys another update as soon as we got the valve cover completely stripped and this area completed. Guys can see here, the paint's actually all the way dry, so well, I covered the majority of like the chassis of the car in this area right here, but it came out well, quite nice though. It's just this line right here that I taped up, you can actually see, but other than that it actually blend in very well. Like this top part right here I didn't respray at all, and the majority of like the well things in the engine bay actually covered. Like this I covered, that I covered, this wires I covered, the power wire covered. So I just need to reassemble everything, then we will be sorted in this area. As you guys can see right here, we got the valve cover fully prepped. We just need to like rub either some Vaseline or some fix or something on this Mugen and this area right here. What I actually want to do is actually tape it up with some masking tape and cut it out, especially this area right here, because to get like the Vaseline on this area is going to be a little bit tough to get it like perfect the way I want it. And I'm not very concerned about like covering the rest of the things, but just the Mugen and this part right here. So I'm first gonna see what I can do, but thus far the paint stripper did a absolute amazing job of like removing the paint on the valve cover. As you guys can see, we got it fully prepped. I'm almost done with the bracket, because Tyron, where's the bracket? Well, there's the bracket. Almost done with the bracket. We got most of the rust off the bracket, and well guys, as you guys can see, we're almost done. Well, say 50% 50% complete, but that area looks way better like being resprayed. And guys, this was a can, I'm not gonna lie, we literally used a can, and this can is empty, but this was the can I actually used. If many of you guys were wondering what can of spray I used, I first used some of this well white primer, and then after that I used this white can of spray. I never actually use this because well, it gives too much overspray, and I was fortunately gives like a lot of like drops like on the paint, and I didn't like feel for well any further imperfections. But at the moment this will have to do. Well, me and Tyron, we've been busy the entire day just like prepping everything and getting everything sprayed. So now we're actually gonna attempt to respray the valve cover. Very basic. All you do, you just spray on the VHT. After each coat you let it set, but use a blow dryer or heat gun to get like the wrinkle out of the paint. Very basic. You don't need to like prep your valve cover all the way perfect like we did. You can literally just blow over, like you can just like sand it down, and then you can spray over the VHT wrinkle spray, because like the wrinkle like covers up all the imperfections on the valve cover. But in my current situation, I just wanted to do everything 110% perfect, because I want some amazing results in this engine bay. As you guys can see, a job well done this far, especially in that area right there. And I actually checked out online how to like tuck like the fuse box in the cabrio. Very basic. It's just not going to be in the cabrio, but it's going to be like behind the cabrio. So I was thinking of that. The only problem I'm having at the moment is like getting like the power wire running all the way to the cabin of the car, but that's quite basic as well. So I might attempt that in the future, but for now I'm perfectly fine with the results. So I'm not sure if I'm gonna get the car fully completed tonight, but I'm gonna get the valve cover resprayed, and I most probably will have to push in the car, because like I said, the valve cover most probably needs some time to dry. So I might just let it dry overnight, and then we can actually get it mounted well tomorrow on a separate video, or it might just be the same video. So let's just get the valve cover resprayed real quick and the brake.
Thank you.
guys, this is the progress as far. So we got this area completely resprayed, which doesn't look too bad, to be honest. So I'm gonna show you guys tomorrow with better lighting. We got the valve cover resprayed. There's not much wrinkle on the valve cover at the moment, so as soon as the motor is gonna heat up and actually drive with the car, then it's actually gonna wrinkle up, because like I said, I did not have a heat gun. And I actually got these brackets resprayed, and like this gasket, it goes onto the valve cover. I got them resprayed black as well. There's actually one that's on the valve cover. I couldn't get that one off, but got most of the brackets resprayed, got the valve cover resprayed, got that area resprayed right there. But tonight we're just gonna push in the car, and then we will continue tomorrow. We already got most of the stuff packed up, and as you guys can see, valve cover's on the car. The reservoir is hanging right there. There's earth laying right there. We don't have the fuse box on, so I'm definitely gonna continue tomorrow. The reason why I'm will be doing two videos is because I know you guys actually want some content, so I will be splitting this video into two videos to actually complete the engine bay. So hope you guys appreciate that. Please leave this video a like, please subscribe, and please to follow me with more later content. Please follow me on Instagram as well, because like I said, we hit 10,000 followers on Instagram, so we have the swipe up option. Super grateful for that. Super grateful for the 19,000 subscribers. I see we're almost on 19,200, so super thankful for that as well. But guys, remember, stop racing and go stunts. And remember, part 2 of this video will be released after this one.